Yes, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the MU Stand. This is your match reaction. Nottingham Forest nil, Manchester United 3. What a performance. I mean, it's been a very good performance by Man United. Very professional, very solid performance. I don't think we did anything wrong in this match. I don't think for a second I thought United were going to concede. I mean, it's been a very comfortable game. Comfortable game. One of the best, I would say one of the best performances I've seen from this team. Obviously, Marcus Rashford continues to score. He is red hot. I mean, Rashford, they could not stop him. Weghorst got on the score sheet as well. That came in the second goal. Weghorst got his first goal for Manchester United. And Bruno Fernandes just wrapped it up. We just destroyed Nottingham Forest. And I think this tie is over. Not only this game, but the tie is over. I think we're going to be in the final. And I think whoever it is in the final, we are going to win. But let's get into the players' rating. Before we do, don't forget to smash a like on the video and subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. But let's take a look at the players' rating really, really quickly for this matchup. Obviously, David De Gea in goal. He was solid. I think he was solid in this match. Didn't put anything wrong. He didn't do anything wrong in this game. I think he was really, really solid. Wan-Bissaka is also, he's continuing his form. We just need him to do a bit more offensively, but defensively, Wan-Bissaka has shown us that he's a very good defender. Lindelof came in for Varane, and he did okay. 7.2, he did fine. In the beginning, in the first half, he had two incidents. Nottingham Forest had a couple of shots on goal. He made a few mistakes here and there, but after that, I think he was solid. After that, I think he was solid alongside Martinez. Martinez didn't put anything wrong, didn't put a foot wrong in this match. Back four, all of them played well. Malacia as well. I would like to see, like I said, I would like to see more offensively from Malacia and Wan-Bissaka, but defensively, they've shown us that they're solid. We can't judge them only purely on this game, obviously, because this is Nottingham Forest we're talking about. It's not like we played prime Real Madrid. So the team didn't put us under pressure. I mean, Nottingham Forest didn't create a lot of chances. Is it down to us playing really well, defending really well, closing all the spaces, or is it because of their quality? They're just not a quality team, and they don't have enough quality to break us down. So you could decide on that, but I think I would like to give them credit that we haven't conceded in this game. In the middle of the park, Casemiro's back. You know what, baby? When Casa is back, when Casemiro's back, we are winning a game. And that's what happened. We won this game. Casemiro's back again, and we won this game. Alongside Eriksen, Eriksen dictated the game. He was basically supplying a chance for the likes of Antony, Rashford, and Bruno Fernandes from deep. And he did his job today. Let me just take a look at what we got. Okay, Antony. So Antony's another one I want to cover before I finish this video. Antony is, it's a question mark. I mean, in terms of performance, is he really performing? Probably not. But I think we need to be patient. I think we need to give him more time. I think we need to give him more time to settle in. And I know, like, people are asking questions. Some people are calling him a YouTube player because all he does is flicks and tricks, and he's not proactive, and he's not producing. His end result is not really that positive. I think that's going to change. We just want him to take on players. We just want him to dribble past players, not be scared to take on players one-on-one. Just look at Garnacho. I mean, I don't think Garnacho is more talented than Antony, but it's just the fact that Garnacho has no fear whatsoever. If he makes a mistake, he makes some mistakes, but he's going to take on the defense. And I would like to see the same from Antony. Bruno Fernandes, Probably man of the match, in my opinion. It's between him and Rashford, 8.3. I think he did really good, Bruno Fernandes. He did really good. I'm glad that he got his goal at last. He got his goal at last. He deserved that goal, by the way. He really, really deserved that goal. It was a good hit, assist by Ilanga. Good hit to make a 3-0. And all game long, I think he was creating chances here and there for the forwards. So I think he deserves man of the match, in my opinion. Okay, who we got? Marcus Rashford. So Marcus Rashford is another one in contention for the man of the match award, but he was taken off 60 minutes in. So I would say probably you would go towards Bruno Fernandes because he played more minutes. He stayed on longer in the game. But Rashford, again, hot in form. He did his thing in the first half, dribbled past two players and puts the ball in the back of the net. You don't see that a lot. I mean, I know people are gassing up Haaland, but people need to take a look at Rashford. Not just the goals, not just the number of goals, but look at how the goals are being scored. And this guy is actually creating his own chance and scoring. So I think we need to applaud that. Finally, Weghorst. I'm happy that he got on the score sheet. I did criticize him in the past few games. I wasn't impressed with Weghorst in the past few games against Crystal Palace. He did not offer us anything against Arsenal as well. But in this game, he's like a kind of player you don't really see him much, but he does something for the team. I think in today, it might help him moving forward because he scored and he got on the score sheet. So that's probably a good thing that he got on the score sheet. Maybe he can kick on and start his career at Man United. But I'm happy. I'm really, really happy that he got on the score sheet. From off the bench, Garnacho came on. Pelstri came on. Ilanga finally came on. And you can't really rate them. I thought Garnacho did try a few tricks and flicks in the second half. They weren't just coming for him. Ilanga got on the assist for Bruno Fernandes' goal. I believe I mentioned that already. But it's good, guys. It's good. So looking forward to the second leg. Second leg, I think it should be an easy one now. For the second leg, I think we can put in any players. We can play the likes of Ilanga, Garnacho, Pelstri, all these players that were on the bench today, we can actually start them in the second leg because I think this tie is over. So we could definitely start these players in the second leg and give them more minutes to play. And hopefully they'll do better and we get ourselves in the final. I mean, we are in the final. I mean, regardless of what happens in the second leg, I don't think we're going to lose 3-0. I just don't see Nottingham Forest coming into Old Trafford and scoring 3 goals. I really can't see that happening, even with our B team. So it's not going to happen. I think we are in the final, and it looks like we're going to face Newcastle because Newcastle have won away from home against Southampton. So we're going to be facing Newcastle. I'm not scared of Newcastle. I think if you told me we're going to be playing Newcastle to win a cup, I'll take it. I'll take it. Every day of the week, I'll take that. So if we face them in the final, I'm not worried about Newcastle. I think we're going to go ahead and win this trophy, and we're going to clear up the drought at United. The last time we won a trophy is with, I think, Jose Mourinho, 2017. So it's been 5 to 6 years now. So it's about time that we need to win a trophy for the state. But yeah, guys, man of the match. Who has been your man of the match? Let me know in the comment sections. Mine was Bruno Fernandes. So do let me know in the comment section. Again, thanks for watching the video. Smash a like on the video. Subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. And I will see you on the next one. Peace.